Hi, in the previous lectures we have been discussing brute force substring search, but we have come to the conclusion that we can do better with the help of the Boyer-Moore search. So again, what's the aim of Boyer-Moore substring search algorithm? As we have seen for the brute force search one, that for example we would like to find a given pattern, for example the public, and this Notepad++ software is able to find it without any problem. So this is the pattern, and this is what we are looking for in a given text. This is the text, okay. So that's the problem itself. And we have talking about brute force search, and the problem with brute force search is that we keep considering too many bad options as well. Maybe we can eliminate a lot of possibilities. That's why Boyer-Moore algorithm came to be. It's very efficient string search algorithm, and the algorithm needs to preprocess the pattern, but not the whole text. It's very important that the algorithm just have to preprocess the pattern itself. The algorithm runs faster as the length of the pattern increases, and the key features of the algorithm are to match on the tail of the pattern rather than the head. We have been talking about brute force search algorithm, and we check the first character starting with the leftmost character of the pattern. Here for Boyer-Moore we are going to start with the rightmost characters. Okay, why is it good? Because we can skip multiple characters at the same time rather than searching every single character in the text. Okay, so first we have to construct a bad match table with the help of the pattern. This is the preprocessing stage, and this table never has elements smaller than 1. We keep comparing the pattern to the text starting from the rightmost character in the pattern, and when a mismatch occurs, we have to shift the pattern to the right corresponding to the value in the bad match table. So this is why we have to construct the bad match table to be able to know how many characters to shift the given pattern. Why is it good again? Because we can skip several characters unlike brute force search, and eventually the algorithm will be faster. So what about this bad match table? We have to make a table of the characters, okay. Make sure the table doesn't contain repetitive characters. So if there are several A characters in the pattern, the bad match table only contains one A letter. And this is the equation or the formula we are going to use. We have to take the maximum out of 1 and the length of the pattern minus the actual index of the character in the pattern minus 1. So we iterate over the pattern and compute the values to the bad match table. And we keep updating the old values for the same characters because the table doesn't contain repetitive characters. And it's very important that this bad match table is constructed out of the pattern, not the text, so we don't have to preprocess the whole text. If we have a book, for example, with 500 pages, we don't have to preprocess that given book. We just have to preprocess the pattern we are looking for. So in this case, we don't have to preprocess this given text. We just have to preprocess the substring we are looking for. For example, the public keyword. In this case, Boyer-Moore algorithm is going to construct a bad match table out of the pattern. So that's why in this case we just have to consider this given word. Okay, so let's see how it works. We have the text and we have the pattern. So we are looking for the test word in the this is a test text. Okay. We just have to iterate through the pattern and we have to construct the bad match table. As you can see, there are two character T in the original pattern, but the bad match table contains only a single character T. So, for example, what about T? T is the first character, so the index is equals to 0, so we have to choose the maximum out of 1. Length of the pattern is 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 minus the index of the actual character, which is 0. So 4 minus 0 minus 1. What is greater, 1 or 3? Of course, 3. What about the next character in the pattern? It is character E. It has an index 1 because 0 is the T, 1 is the E. then 2 is the S, and 3 is the T. Length of pattern is 4, 4 minus the index, which is 1, minus 1. What's the maximum? 1 or 2? Of course 2, that's why the value will be 2 associated with the character E. What about the next character, S? Length of the pattern is 4, index is equals to 2, minus 1. 4 minus 2 minus 1 is equals to 1. What is greater, 1 or 1? It doesn't matter. So the value is going to be 1 associated with character S. Okay, what about the last character in the pattern? As we can see, it is the T, but we have already have a T value in our bad match table. The value was 3. And this is what extremely important, that if we have the same character again, we just have to update the value accordingly. So, in this case, the length of the pattern is 4, the index of actual character is 3 minus 1, so 4 minus 3 minus 1, it is 0, the maximum out of 1 and 0 is 1, so that's why we have updated the value for character T to 1. So it was 3, but after we have considered the same character, we have updated the bad match table accordingly. And this star represents any other character that's not present in the pattern, and we are going to have the value, the length of the pattern. So basically, it's going to be 4. What does it mean? That when we are going to run our Boyer-Moore algorithm, if we have to make a shift, we are going to look it up in the bad match table. If the character at that actual index in the text is S, we have to make a shift 1 to the right. If it is E, we have to make 2 steps to the right. If it is T, we have to make 1 step to the right. And anyways, we have to make 4 steps to the right. And why is it good? Because unlike brute force search, we are able to take several steps at the same time. Okay, so in the next lecture, we are going to take a look at a concrete example concerning the Boyer-Moore algorithm. Thanks for watching.